Guys, welcome back to Java tutorials. In this video I will talk about what is interfaces in Java and also uses and implementation of interfaces. Let's get started. Interface is a special type of classes which are useful for 100% abstraction. We already know like abstract classes are useful for partial abstraction. If in case we need full abstraction, we need interfaces. The keywords we will see while dealing with interfaces are implements and interface. Now let's write some coding example. To create an interface, first thing is we need to declare the name as interface. Then only it is interface, otherwise it is a class. In this interface, we have two abstract methods. Let's say public void method one. Let's take one more method, public void method 2. These methods called as abstract methods where it doesn't have a implementation, right? Now let's have a class name hello implements my interface. What does this mean? A class that implements the interface. Now let's see the error here. It must be declared as abstract or implement abstract methods. So either you have to declare this class as abstract or implement methods. Let's implement methods. Let's say okay. Now the error is gone. And you can see the implementation part here where you can add some code, depends on the requirement. Let's say system.out.println method 1. Let's write something for second method, method 2, Java interfaces. So that's how you have to create an interface and implement those methods. If any method is not implemented, it immediately throws the compile time error. Calling those methods is pretty straightforward. Public static void main. We need to create the object for class hello obj equal to new hello obj and obj dot method 1. Let's save the code and run. When you run the code, we can see the implementation part here in the console. So in this video we have seen what is interfaces and implementation of the interfaces. Hey guys, welcome back to Java tutorials. In this video I will talk about what is multiple interfaces. So in my previous example we have seen what is interfaces and its implementation. In this video I will talk about how to deal with multiple interfaces. The first thing is I created an interface in that I have two abstract classes. Let's take only one abstract class. And let's create one more interface, my interface 2, this is 1, and let's have a method here, public void method 2. So is it clear, right? We have interface 1 and interface 2. Let's have a class here, say demo implements my interface 1, right? So what we are doing here, we are implementing only the first interface. In that case, it asks only one method. Just implement the method, say first method implementation. So what we can do now, we can create an object. So what we can do, we can call this method in public static void main. For that let's create a object, demo obj equals to new demo obj dot method 1. Let's save the code and run. So far it's easy and straightforward. What if you want to implement this interface also? We can do like this, my interface 2. This one is called as multiple interfaces. So immediately we need to implement this abstract method, right? So that's the reason the compiler throwing error. To avoid that one, you have to implement the method is method 2. That's it. Let's call that method also and complete that one before calling second method implementation. Save the code and run. Here you go. If you remember when we are talking about inheritance concept, these multiple inheritances not supported by Java, but in multiple interfaces it works. So using this multiple interfaces feature, we can implement. This is the concept of multiple interfaces. That's all for today's tutorial, guys. In my next video, I'll talk about more examples. Hey guys, welcome back to Java Tutorials and part 3 of interfaces. In this video, you will see the main advantage of using this multiple interfaces or interfaces concept. We already know, like, using these interfaces, we will get 100% abstraction, right? And also we can restrict some methods. That is the main advantage of multiple interfaces. Let's understand further in this example. This one we have seen for previous example. Let's recap. So we have interface 1 and interface 2, a class that implements two interfaces. Immediately we need to implement those incomplete methods, right? So that's the reason I implemented these two methods. And what I did here, I just called those two methods. If the situation is like, if you want to implement like these two methods, why do we want these two interfaces and implement those two methods here and calling those methods here? It's so confusing, right? I'm coming there only. So we know, like, we have two abstract methods here, but we don't want to give the access to interface 2. In that case, you simply delete this one so that you cannot access this method. So this is the one way of restricting the method. Let us also try in another way, core concept of today's video. So here we created object reference for the class, right? Instead of creating for the class, let's do it for interface. Let's say interface 2. Do you understand now what I'm doing? It immediately not accepting the method. So in this case, you can only access one method here. That is the main purpose of creating interfaces, where there are many methods. You can give access to only few methods and you can restrict some of other methods. Even though if you want to access the other methods, the compiler immediately throws the error. You can also try and check for the interface 1. Now this one is showing error. That is the main purpose of interfaces. I hope you understand the concept very well. If you have still doubts, you can follow my tutorial from the beginning, at least from the interfaces tutorial 1, so that you will catch up everything. Hey guys, welcome back to Java Tutorials and part 5 of interfaces concept. Today's video about inheritance concept in interfaces. So we already seen interface concept in my previous videos. Basically, if you extend one class to another class, that is called as interface. But you can also implement or extend one interface to another interface using extend keyword. What does that mean? We will see in this example. Let's have one interface and one abstract method here. Let's also have one more interface. Name my interface 2, where you can take one more method, say method 2. If you have two interfaces, we can access those interfaces in a class using multiple inheritance, right? Let's say class demo implements my interface 1, my interface 2. Using this, you can implement those interface methods right here. So far it's clear, right? Now let's go back and remove one interface. Now you can see only one method here, right? Let's implement my interface tool. This one shows error, remove this one. And it only implements again method 2, which is in my interface 2. This one also pretty straightforward. Our target is we have to implement only one interface. In that interface, you can access all the methods. Is it tricky? No, not at all. I already gave a clue, like this is a concept of inheritance. So what you will do, we can use the advantage of inheritance concept. Extends my interface 1. The advantage of using this inheritance concept in interfaces is you can extend or you can implement only one interface, but you can access all the interfaces methods, and that's it. Just one click at a time, you can access all the interface methods, but make sure you have to extend that one. And remain stuff is same, there is no difference. Let's create reference for my interface 2 and call those methods. If you keenly observed my previous videos, using interface object reference, you can only call those methods, not other methods. But in this program, we use this inheritance concept using this extends keyword. That's the reason you can call those two methods. This is the advantage of inheritance concept. Hope you understand the concept very well. Hey guys, welcome back to Java Tutorials and part 4 of interfaces. In this video, I will talk about what is upcasting and downcasting in perspective of interfaces. First of all, if we think about interfaces concept, the generic point we should remember is we cannot initialize a object, means it cannot be instantiated. So far it's clear, right? You cannot create object for interfaces. So this example we have seen before. Let's go over what we have here. We have two interfaces that implements these two interfaces. This one is called as multiple interfaces. And in the main method, let's create object for an interface. My interface 1 equals to new my interface. Look, immediately it is asking the implementation of the method here. So if you remove this one, it immediately throws the error. So we cannot create object for the interfaces. So far it's clear, right? So we already know, like, we can create object for the class so that we can access the methods for interfaces. Obj dot method 1, obj dot method 2. So these examples we are seeing once we started object oriented concepts. Nothing new here, but I just wanted to go with the flow. That's the reason I'm explaining again. But we can do like this. Instead of demo, we can create a object reference for my interface 1. Looking immediately, it is not accepting second interface methods. So this means if you can create reference for one interface, you can only accept those methods, not outside methods, means not other methods. This is clear, right? So what is this called as? This is upcasting. Upcasting is fine, but if you do downcasting, it's not possible. Let me show that one also. Downcasting. What is downcasting means? Suppose interface you can take class, creating a object for class, right? Let's take the interface. Instead of class, let's type interface name here. Maybe we can see the error. This is the abstract class and it cannot be instantiated, so we cannot do this one. I said like downcasting is not possible. Hope you understand the terminology called as what is upcasting and downcasting in this video. Hey guys, welcome back to Java tutorials and part 6 of interfaces. And you feel like this interface concept is very lengthy. I do agree, but I wanted to teach you as much as I can. This is the last video for sure. But remember, this is very important topic. So far we have seen abstract classes is used for 100% abstraction, and you have all abstract methods, means incomplete methods. But in addition to this, from Java 8 onwards, we have another advantage. We can have concrete methods. Using default keyword, we can use the regular methods also, not only the abstract methods. But before Java 8, the interfaces are only used for abstract methods. We should not use regular methods. If you want to have concrete methods, the interfaces is not allowing. But in real scenarios, the situation is different. You should need to have some methods also. That's the reason Java 8 introduced this feature. Let's see how to do that one. We have an interface and one abstract method. Let's create a concrete method now. Concrete method and regular method is same actually. Don't get confused. But you should need to remember we have to give a default keyword. Void method. This is method 2 implementation. So in this interface we have one abstract method and one concrete method. Let's have a class demo implements my interface 1. But once we implement the interface, it asks implement the methods. But we know like method 2 is regular method. You no need to implement that one here. You can only implement the method 1, or you can only implement the abstract method. This abstract method implementation. You need to understand the implementation part here. This is a key thing if you are talking about Java 8 functional interfaces. And rest of the stuff is same. You just have a main method and a object reference. And second important thing you should remember here is we can call abstract methods and non-abstract methods. I mean concrete methods. Just run the code and see the implementation here. That's it guys. That's all about interfaces. So the interfaces concept is useful for abstraction. We can implement the interfaces using implements keyword. One class implements multiple interfaces. And the advantage of multiple interfaces or interface concept is we can restrict some methods to the user. And here also upcasting and downcasting applicable, which is similar to typecasting concept. And we already seen how to take the advantage of inheritance concept and what is the latest update for interfaces, that is Java 8 functional interfaces. All these concepts are sub-concepts of interfaces. Very important thing to understand. And if you keenly observe, this is similar to interface, right? Because when you add this concrete method, it looks like abstract classes, but there are some similarities and differences if you compare with the abstract classes and interfaces. So our next concept is about what is differences and similarities between abstract classes and interfaces. So let's meet up in next video. Meanwhile, stay tuned and happy learning.